quiet, numbskulls. I'm broadcasting.
The medical marijuana. The medical marijuana. Radio. Radio. Show.
The medical marijuana for you and me. Ah, yeah, the medical marijuana. Whoa, 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 yeah, the medical. It's the medical marijuana show. You knew we know.
I wanna talk to you.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome once again to another edition of Medical Marijuana Radio for Saturday, the 19th of September, 2015. I'm your host, Larry Love. We're here every week to bring you the latest information and all the good stories and interesting stuff about medical cannabis and adult use from all over the globe. This week we have a really great interview. You know, we always talk about testing. And there's controversy, some of the shops don't want to test because it costs them money, and even though it's mandatory. So there are here in New Mexico, we now have 3 labs. Testing has been mandatory now, and we'll have to see whether the Department of Health will actually enforce their own rules. But meantime, we have 2 guests on today. From CB Scientific, Alan and Henry, and we're going to talk about home testing kits. They have a kit that you can actually at home test your bud, test your edibles, and come up with how much THC and how much CBD is in there. So we're really happy to have had them, and we'll be playing that at the second half of the show. So meanwhile, before that though, we've got some news for you. 1, 2, 3. So,
I've got news.
First up, this week the Republicans had their debate, and there was some talk about medical and recreational cannabis. We have to be aware of what's going on out there. It was a widely seen debate. However, I wanted to play some clips from it. And first up is Rand Paul talking about fighting for marijuana and drug policy. He makes some good points, actually, but all in all, you have to listen for what the Republicans really feel about cannabis. And here's this first clip.
Many people on social media wanted us to ask about marijuana legalization. Senator Paul, Governor Christie recently said, quote, "If you're getting high in Colorado today, where marijuana has been legalized, enjoy it until January 2017, because I will enforce the federal laws against marijuana. Will you?"
I think one of the great problems and what the American people don't like about politics is hypocrisy. People who have one standard for others and not for them for themselves. There's at least one prominent example on the stage of someone who says they smoked pot in high school. And yet the people going to jail for this are poor people, often African Americans and often Hispanics. And yet the rich kids who use drugs aren't. I personally think that this is a crime for which the only victim is the individual. And I think that America has to take a different attitude. I'd like to see more rehabilitation and less incarceration. I'm a fan of the drug courts, which try to direct you back towards work and less time in jail. But the bottom line is the states, we say we like the 10th Amendment until we start talking about this. And I think the federal government's gone too far. I think that the war on drugs has had a racial outcome. and really has been something that's really damaged our inner cities. Not only do the drugs damage them, we damage them again by incarcerating them and then preventing them from getting employment over time. So I don't think that the federal government should override the states. I believe in the 10th Amendment, and I really will say that the states are left to themselves.
I want to give the person that you called a hypocrite an opportunity to respond. Do you want to identify that person?
Well, I think if we left it open, we could see how many people smoked pot in high school.
Is there somebody you were specifically thinking of?
Well, you know, the thing is,
he was talking about me.
Yeah, I was talking
about... I wanted to make it easier for him.
Yeah.
Okay. And I just did.
Governor Bush, please.
So 40 years ago, I smoked marijuana, and I admit it. I'm sure that other people might have done it and may not want to say it in front of 25 million people. My mom's not happy that I just did. That's true. But here's the deal. Here's the deal. We have a serious epidemic of drugs that goes way beyond marijuana. What goes on in Colorado, as far as I'm concerned, that should be a state decision. But if you look at the problem of drugs in this society today, it's a serious problem. Rand, you know this because you're campaigning in New Hampshire like all of us, and you see the epidemic of heroin, the overdoses of heroin that's taking place. People's families are being torn apart. It is appropriate for the government to play a consistent role to be able to provide more treatment, more prevention. We're the state that has the most drug courts. Across every circuit in Florida, there are drug courts to give people a second chance. That's the best way to do this.
But let me respond. The thing is that in Florida, Governor Bush campaigned against medical marijuana. That means that a small child like Morgan Hintz that has 500 seizures a day is failing on 9 traditional medications, is not allowed to use cannabis oil, and that if they attempt to do that in Florida, they will take the child away, they will put the parents in jail, and that's what that means. If you're against allowing people to use medical marijuana, you'll actually put them in jail.
Ray,
and actually,
wrong,
under the current circumstances, kids who had privilege like you do don't go to jail, but the poor kids in our inner cities go to jail. I don't think that's fair, and I think that we need to acknowledge it, and it is hypocritical to still want to put poor people in jail.
I don't want to put poor people in jail, Rand.
Well,
here's the deal.
You oppose medical marijuana?
No, I did not oppose when the legislature passed the bill to deal with that very issue. That's the way to solve this problem. Medical marijuana on the ballot was opened up. There's a huge loophole. It was the first step towards getting to a Colorado place. And as a citizen of Florida, I voted no.
But that means you'll put people in jail.
I want to go right now. You brought my issue up. That's true. Go ahead, Christine, please.
You know, I enjoyed the interplay. Thank you, gentlemen. I just say this. You know, first off, New Jersey is the first state in the nation that now says if you are a nonviolent, non-dealing drug user, that you don't go to jail for your first offense. You go to mandatory treatment. You see, as Jake, I'm pro-life, and I think you need to be pro-life for more than just the time in the womb. It gets a lot tougher when they get out of the womb. And when they're the 16-year-old drug addict on the floor of the county lockup, that life is just as precious as the life in the womb. And so that's why I'm for rehabilitation, why I think the war on drugs has been a failure. But I'll end with this. That doesn't mean we should be legalizing gateway drugs. And if Senator Paul thinks that the only victim is the person, look at the decrease in productivity. Look at the way people get used and move on to other drugs when they use marijuana as a gateway drug. It's not them that are the only victims. Their families are the victims, too. Their children are the victims, too. And their employers are the victims, also. And that's why I'll enforce the federal law, while you can still put an emphasis on rehabilitation, which you've done in New Jersey.
Yeah, you may respond, and then I'll bring in you, Ms. Fiorina.
Understand what they're saying. If they're going to say, we are going to enforce the federal law against what the state law is, they aren't really believing in the 10th Amendment. Governor Christie would go into Colorado, and if you're breaking any federal law on marijuana, even though the state law allows it, he would put you in jail. If a young mother is trying to give her child cannabis oil for medical marijuana for seizure treatment, he would put her in jail if it violates federal law. I would let Colorado do what the 10th Amendment says. This power, we were never intended to have crime dealing at the federal level. Crime was supposed to be left to the states. Colorado's made their decision, and I don't want the federal government interfering and putting moms in jail who are simply trying to get medicine for their kid.
And Senator Paul knows that that's simply not the truth. In New Jersey, we have medical marijuana laws, which I've supported and implemented. This is not medical
marijuana.
This goes a much further step beyond. This is recreational use of marijuana. This is much different. And so while he'd like to use a sympathetic story to back up his point, it doesn't work. I'm not against medical marijuana. We do it in New Jersey. But I am against the recreational use of marijuana. If he wants to change the federal law, get Congress to pass a law to change it and get a president to sign it.
May I respond?
Yes, Senator Paul.
Here's the thing is he doesn't want to make it about medical marijuana. But what if New Jersey's medical marijuana contradicts the federal law? He's saying he will send the federal government in and he will enforce the federal law. That's not consistent with the 10th Amendment. It's not consistent with states' rights. And it's not consistent with a conservative vision for the country. I don't think we should be sending the federal police in to arrest a mother and separate them from their child for giving a medicine to their child for seizures.
And Jake, well,
So at least there's some voice of reason up there. Rand Paul is some kind of a doctor, but Chris Christie should be ashamed of himself. I was born in New Jersey, and I'm just embarrassed from him. He is such a liar. You know, he's been against that medical marijuana program in New Jersey. He's hindered it. He's caused suffering. I'm not even still sure if they have edibles there. He should be embarrassed, and he should not be allowed up there. He's just a terrible human being, and I'm on record saying that. All in all, though, it was an interesting debate. But here's more. Here is a clip that somebody on one of the news channels did with all those GOP candidates making their comments on cannabis. So here is this clip of all of them.
There's at least one prominent example on the stage of someone who says they smoked pot in high school. And yet the people who are going to jail for this are poor people, often African-Americans and often Hispanics. And yet the rich kids who use drugs aren't.
I'm going to give the person that you called a hypocrite an opportunity to respond. Do you want to identify that person?
Well, I think if we left it open, we could see how many people smoked pot in high school. You know, the thing is...
He was talking about me.
Yeah, I was talking
about... That's what I thought, but I wanted him to say it.
But I wanted to make it easier for him. Yeah. So 40 years ago, I smoked marijuana, and I admit it. I'm sure that other people might have done it and may not want to say it in front of 25 million people. My mom's not happy that I just did.
If Senator Paul thinks that the only victim is the person, look at the decrease in productivity, look at the way people get used and move on to other drugs when they use marijuana as a gateway drug. It's not them that are the only victims, their families are the victims too.
My husband Frank and I buried a child to drug addiction. We are misleading young people when we tell them that marijuana is just like having a beer. It's not. And the marijuana that kids are smoking today is not the same as the marijuana that Jeb Bush smoked 40 years ago. Sorry.
So that was a conglomeration of all the comments from the debate. Stephen Colbert, who took over for David Letterman last week, also commented on the talk on that debate about cannabis. And he said that wasn't a debate, it was an intervention.
Not everyone came out looking as good as Ms. Fiorina. We learned some shocking news last night about one of the candidates.
I think one of the great problems and what the American people don't like about politics is hypocrisy. People who have one standard for others and not for themselves. There's at least one prominent example on the stage of someone who says they smoked pot in high school.
Way to be a narc, Rand. Excuse me. Excuse me, Mr. Tapper. One of my competitors is a doper. Oh, and you forgot to give us homework, sir. Come on. Well, so who burned down Officer Buzz Shackler?
Do you want to identify that person?
Well, you know, the thing is
he was talking about me.
Yeah, I was talking
That's
about...
That's what I thought, but well, I wanted him to say it.
I wanted to make it easier for him,
yeah. Okay.
And I just did.
Governor Bush, please.
So 40 years ago, I smoked marijuana, and I admit it.
Jeb Bush is a pothead. Oh. That explains a lot. He isn't low energy, he's baked. Governor Kush put down the spleef. Now I know why there were so many people on that stage. This wasn't a debate, it was an intervention. We love you, Jeb, and we just want to help you. Stick around.
Governor Kush. Anyway, God forbid any of those people get in. But on the other side of things, here is Bernie Sanders, who's making a real surge and is actually beating Hillary Clinton in certain states and could could well be the nominee. Here is what Bernie Sanders has to say about medical marijuana.
One of the things you mentioned in that answer had to do with sort of reforming or reevaluating the war on drugs.
This was not at the debate, by the way. This is just his comment.
One of the issues that hasn't gotten a whole lot of play in this presidential campaign so far, and not only yours, but in the campaign of others, is the decriminalization of marijuana. Do you have a policy position on that?
Well, my state of Vermont has decriminalized marijuana, and I support that.
Okay.
In other words, if you are possessing a small amounts of marijuana, it should not be a criminal offense, it should be a civil, you might want to pay a fine on that. I support marijuana use for medical purposes, and we're exploring the pluses and minuses, of which there are both, of moving more aggressively on that area. It is a very important issue. We're watching what Colorado is doing, and we'll have more to say about that in the coming weeks and months.
So do you believe it is the purview of the federal government to legislate the criminalization of marijuana?
What the federal government can do is say to the state of Colorado that if you choose to vote to legalize marijuana, we will allow you to do that without restrictions. In other words, right now, as I understand it, in Colorado, people who run marijuana shops can't put their money in banks, for example. That's a violation of federal law. So I think there are things that the federal government can do that would make it easier for states that want to go in that direction to be able to do so.
Would you be in favor of having the federal government be more active in moving towards that direction?
That's something we will have more to say about. It's a very good question, and it's a fair question. Let me not jump on what I want to be more thoughtful about in the coming weeks and months.
Sure.
So that's the position of Bernie Sanders, as opposed to all those GOP candidates. Bernie obviously says some great things. We'll have to see how this momentum keeps going. Next up, and right before we take a little break and come back with our interview with CB Scientific, something new in Colorado, it's always going to be something. Gas and grass, gas stations, there's a couple of gas stations opening up that if you have a medical card, will also sell you your meds. Gas and grass in Colorado.
You go into the gas station to fill up, and while the car is gassing up, you run inside the store to buy medical marijuana. Well, that's exactly what people in the Springs will be able to do starting in October. Let's check the facts first on this story. Native Roots is opening up two gas and grass locations, and one on Academy and Galley, and the other will be near Uinta and North 17th Street. Now, people have mixed feelings about this new business. And Fox 21's Cody Fisher joins us now with more on this story tonight. Cody?
Joe, these gas stations are expanding Native Roots' large number of dispensaries in the state. Now, the combination of a gas station and medical marijuana is a first, and it's starting conversations about the pros and cons of the idea.
The locations will have everything normal gas stations have, just with medical marijuana for patients with a card.
We figured this gave the opportunity to potentially take a stop off their trips and just give them one more opportunity to shop with us.
Some are impressed by this idea.
Kind of continues the convenience store, you know, everything one-stop shopping, and I don't see a problem with that.
While some say they really like the idea of being able to fill up and get their medical marijuana in the same place, others are not so keen on the idea.
I guess it brings the possibility of somebody smoking and driving a higher chance.
You're not allowed to smoke in our centers, ever. That is a state law, it's local laws. There's many, many rules and regulations in place that prohibit any sort of on-site consumption.
I don't think it should be any more of a concern than going to the liquor store and buying a bottle of booze right there. You know, you have just as much accessibility to drink it in your car than you do at home. So it just has to be on the responsibility of the person to, you know, be honest and be responsible and not do stuff like that.
And Native Roots says public safety is their priority, saying they educate their customers on the laws of smoking and driving. Now, both locations will be open here in the Springs in October. Abby?
So that's gas and grass if you're a medical card holder in Colorado. Very interesting stuff. Okay, we'll be right back with our guests, Alan and Henry from CB Scientific. They have some home testing kits. Everybody wants to know, you know, what's the potency and what kind of cannabinoids are in their medicine. Now you can test at home. So we'll be right back after this.
It's all about the 420 MMJ Radio.
In 1973, under President Nixon, the federal government set up five drug classifications based on risk, Schedule 1 being the most dangerous. What is considered a Schedule 1 drug? Marijuana, LSD, and heroin. What is a Schedule 2 drug? Cocaine. What is a Schedule 3 drug? Anabolic steroids. What is a Schedule 4 drug? Valium. Schedule 5 drugs are considered the least risky. What is considered the least risky drug? Cough preparations with less than 200 milligrams of codeine. And what drugs are not scheduled at all? Alcohol and cigarettes. Why does the federal government consider tobacco and alcohol a low risk and marijuana a high risk? If you answered, I don't know, you answered right. We don't know either. End prohibition now.
I'm Robert Platchorn with Marijuana Facts from the Silver Tour. A new Florida study in the Journal of Molecular and Cellular Neuroscience found that cannabis can slow the effects of Alzheimer's and may in fact be able to halt it entirely. A University of Ohio study showed that people who use marijuana get Alzheimer's at a much lower rate than non-users. Learn more and support the truth at thesilvertour.org. That's thesilvertour.org.
Hi, as you know, over the next few years, the cannabis industry is going to explode into a multi-million dollar industry. 420webdesign.com is your affordable design provider. 420 Web Design prides themselves on fair prices and a grounded staff. They listen to their ganjapreneurs' website needs. Getting into the marijuana industry doesn't need to break your bank. Our sites come with tons of features. Just a few of them include responsive designs for mobile viewers, easy-to-update platforms, built-in SEO and SMO tools, enterprise-level security, video tutorials, database backups, Google Maps, onboard analytics, and much more. This is backed by a decade of website design and development experience. For all of your 420 web design needs, go to 420webdesign.com. Again, 420webdesign.com. Check them out.
Ever had a problem with overcooking your cannabis oil? You probably wanted to rip your hair out when you burned off all the THC, right? I even cried one time when my brownies failed to make a good impression at the party. Well, I stopped crying when I found Magical Butter. Magical Butter is a device with a microprocessor control program sequencer. It was designed by a scientist and a chemist to precisely extract the benefits of various herbs. Magical Butter easily makes botanical butter, oils, tinctures, lotions, sauces, and more. Magical Butter heats your oil and your herbs at the perfect temperature every time. Check us out at magicalbutter.com because it's magical. Okay, there's a lot of science and chemistry involved, but it sure works like magic.
Again, for your tinctures, butter, and oils, that's magicalbutter.com. This is a great appliance. Use coupon code LOVE to get $20 off.
This is Robert Platchorn with Marijuana Facts from the Silver Tour. According to the DEA's administrative law judge, Francis L. Young, marijuana in its natural form is one of the safest therapeutically active substances known to man. In strict medical terms, marijuana is far safer than many foods we commonly consume. Learn more and support more education at thesilvertour.org. That's thesilvertour.org.
The medical marijuana, the medical marijuana, radio show.
Hey, this is Scott from Rare Dangness. You're listening to Medical Marijuana Radio.
And we're back. And online I have today from CB Scientific, I have Alan Mathon and Henry Biza. Is it Biza or Biza?
Both ways.
Okay, thank you very much. Testing for cannabis for potency and contaminants and so forth is very, very important. We've been talking about it here for a few years in New Mexico, and it's a big thing in Colorado and all the legal states. What you have here is called Test for CBD and THC to find out what the potency is. Could tell us about you. These are home kits, right?
Yes. We have two kits. One, what you mentioned, it's called UPrep CB Scientific Test, and it's THC, CBD, and CBN on the title. And this one, it's a laboratory test. It's been you can go right now on domain name uprep.ca. CB Scientific recently signed a contract for worldwide distribution license. It's mean anybody who wants to purchase this testing unit need to go through the CB Scientific. And right now we are in development, new generation here. If you look at it, because we are on Skype with you, you can look at it on the new generation of the box. What they're doing, it's very simple steps, take 10 minutes, and after the client, when you know, will need to grind your bud or flower, and you will do 10 minutes exactly when you receive our test units, you will do the steps. You will send us in prepay envelope vial, and we'll run through our laboratory, and we'll give full test result. And you will set up account with on our website. The account can be anonymous, or you can be under your company. It doesn't matter, on private name. And all this, it's legal and safe and very cost effective. I mean, what you're doing is we have our, let's go say you're looking for potency test kit, you are a grower, and you want to do the testing. Right now you will use our test four kits for THC, what will give you on the spot. In a few minutes, you will know the potency, if it's 2%, 10%. And after, when you want to get full laboratory report, you can use our three version of UPrep test. One will give you the basic understanding what's kind of percentage THC, CBD, CBN, you know, in this is the first test, or you can get test this one plus with the terpenes, plus we have third one what's complete, where you can testing for pesticide, for heavy metals, and this is what right now the public really need.
Absolutely. There's a lot of controversy about testing. I mean, the patients want it, okay? Obviously, it's a heavy cost for the dispensaries who sell these sell the medicine to you know, go to a lab and test. But this is for home use, okay? And I think it's fantastic because there's a lot of home growers that want to test to see what their strains are testing at and so forth. So let's take an example of the THC and CBD test on bud, okay? And you mentioned that it's legal, okay? So let's first start with how it works. You're taking how much of a bud, and how is it being tested? And you're saying that it takes 10 minutes, you can get instant results at home, correct?
Certainly. So you have a couple different detection kits. You have the CBD detection for bud, and you also have the THC detection for bud. And this is a perfectly legal system in which you take a small pinch, and if you're doing it by lab analysis, 0.03 grams, you can use that with a scale to get that amount, and then you can put that inside our detection vial. The next thing you do with the detection vials, you put in the solvent. We have a solvent bottle inside our detection kit. And you squeeze the solvent inside the vial, 1 milliliter, and you have it marked on the bottle where you should, how much you should put in. And finally, you would put in the dye. This is
okay. Just, I'm sorry. You'll have to repeat that. You cut off a little bit. Finally, you have to put in the.
Yeah, finally, you would have to put in the THC dye solution. So this actually brings out the detection whether or not there is THC in your material. You close the lid after you put in your dye solution. Let it sit for 10 minutes. That's the full length of a detection. CBD is a little bit different. That's a totally different detection. Using the same kind of mechanics, you get two vials in this one, and you get a small little solvent bottle. And what you do is you open the first bottle, and there's a little pellet inside, and that's an activator. It catalyzes the reaction, so that makes the reaction faster. And you take your solvent bottle, you put in about a milliliter, and it's marked down there as well, and then you put your butt inside of that as well. You close the lid, you let it set, and tell you how much inside. It'll give you a detection whether or not it is in there or not. And it turns purple. The THC turns red.
Okay, so now that's testing for the presence of THC or CBD. Is it coming up with an actual percentage on the sample?
It is a colorimetric test, so it is qualitative. But the more THC you have in a product, the deeper the color goes, the higher concentration of THC you have. And we are putting the percentages back on the actual chart itself. The UPrep system will give you an exact number of each cannabinoid inside. But that, you have to send away to the lab, and they will allow you to look that up on your phone, on your computer, and it gives you a whole readout of what you have in your material. So that's going to be the more analytical for those who really want to know.
Right.
And this is simple detection for, you know, a mother or father who got a chocolate bar and make sure their child doesn't want to get this chocolate bar and have a different chocolate bar.
Well, tell me, you say it's legal now. So if you're selling these in other states and people are sending back samples to you, how is that legal crossing a state line technically? Because it's a Schedule One.
True. No, here's the thing. With our UPrep detection kit, you actually don't send the bud sample itself to the other state. You send the extraction to the other state, and it's a very small extraction, even less than 0.03%. So that's even going with the guidelines of hemp. So it's a small extraction that gets put inside a small little vial that gets put inside the chromatography machine. That's how your detection goes. It's a couple drops from the extraction. So when you go through the actual production of this kit, you will get a large vial, and inside the large vial, you will put in your bud material, your ground up material. You will shake it, let it sit for about 5 minutes. And when that's finished, you will take a small little dropper and allow the solution to sit at the bottom. You take your dropper and you put one drop inside a small little vial. This is what gets sent. The vial gets sent to the lab. And this contains actually no bud material whatsoever.
I see, but obviously there is THC in it. But
it is just by the, I think it was Geneva Convention 1969 when, you know, international was approved, you know, and made legal if you're sending for about, I think it's 10 ppa or 5 ppa. It's mean when our partners file the patents for the process, you know, to clear with every government, you know, was the putting in the patent and the proof, you know, it's legal in this particular process. It's still legal to cross the borders.
Fantastic. Well, that's really good to know. So just getting back to the test. So if you want to get the UPrep, okay, then you have to send in the vial and then you'll get your results. What's the turnaround time on that?
It's between, if you send this on Monday morning, for example, it can be somewhere between 3 to 5 business days.
Right. Okay. And all right. So you have different kits. The kit that you're talking about that tests for bud and flower material for THC and CBD, what does that kit cost and how many tests do you get out of that?
You know, the THC test for THC, you know, costs $29.95, and we have single and double kit. The single have 3 vials, and usually how's the doing? The first time when you know, we have family in we was with Alan on the show, and we met with family in Denver, and the father was saying, you know, he looking for something to testing, you know, for, you know, THC immediately because he's buying some products, Charlotte Web, and he just bring the example, meaning, you know, Alan, to show him how it's easy, the steps, and he was shocked because the product was so high on THC, mm-hmm. and he was so happy because, and this is what it's our heart, to educate people, make sure the test, make sure doing, you know, correctly, because, you know, it's so important for the patients, you know, to understanding what you're putting in your body.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And to that, so one kit that's $29.95, how many times can you test a bud with that one kit?
Okay. You know, if you think first time, we saying, you know, it's good to do the test and use all those vials on to feel you be comfortable with the testing. Mm-hmm. And after you can do three tests from one bag. It means approximately around $10 cost to you.
Very, very reasonable, obviously. So compared to, you know, a patient, because we're talking about patients here right now, obviously this wouldn't be good for dispensaries to use. They probably use big testing labs. Do you also do that? Are you also a testing lab for dispensaries?
Yeah, the UPREP, it's full license test laboratory result. It's mean, you know, when you get the UPREP result, you have like you will get from laboratory. You know, it's exactly the same. You know, the protocol, everything. You know, the percentages. This is full laboratory report.
So how let's say plus or minus X amount of percent. The results of someone doing this at home with your home kit, and if you took the same sample, you know, to a, you know, Steep Hill Labs or one of the big labs.
Maybe here's a bit confusing on your side. I will give you an example. I spoke to the gentleman. He is doing edibles in California, and he going and he need to do tests, you know, for his edibles. And he's sending tests and charging probably like, I don't know, you know, he need to put 2,500 down and plus, you know, he need to commit 200 tests and it charged him from $90 to $150 per test. Right now, sometimes he send the test and it's so low on the THC, it's mean he waste money. Now he using our test for THC kit to detect which one he want to do by laboratory. And after he using our UPREP for the full scale of the report, because if you do batch of brownies or chocolate or cookies, right now you can test with us for the THC, CBD, CBN, or you can go to the full report. It's mean if you buy some batch and you want to see did it have heavy metal, the batch of the THC oil, or do you have pesticide? I mean, I think, you know, the people need to really look for what you're putting in the food. And the only thing how we can be protected to have quality, how we came with the system, when we give you immediately, let's go say it's very popular, it's travel, and 420 travel, right? And people go and eat so much edibles and saying, hey, I eat this big piece of chocolate and nothing happened to me, and he will get another piece, another piece, another piece, and after he will go sick.
You know? A little bit of an overdose when you it's very important to have edibles tested, obviously, because you know, there was some controversy in Colorado maybe a year and a half, 2 years ago, where I think the cannabis did a bunch of testing of some edible products. And a lot of them came out much lower than they were advertised. So people do get themselves in trouble by, you know, eating more before they've given a chance for the original ingestion to take effect. So
right now we're working with one of those companies to educate the people. Say, why you don't test, you know, for the edibles? Right now in minutes you will see what's the THC, and now if it's low, now we can have maybe a little bit more pieces. If it's high on THC, just you know, right now you will have the detection right away in a few minutes, and now you know what you're doing.
All right, so your edible test, how would they do that? Let's say somebody went to a dispensary, bought a brownie, and wanted to test a piece of it. How much is your kit cost for edibles, and what is the procedure for that? And is that also an instant result without sending it in?
Sure. It's the cost is $39.95 for the kit. It's not instant. You know, take a couple of minutes. Because again, it's on. We call this on the testing on the spot. I mean, you know, or a home or wherever. It's pocket testing. Doesn't matter. Go ahead, Alan. Tell how's the work.
So it's a pretty simple process. We give a larger reaction vial inside this detection kit, and you have your solvent vial. So what you would do, you would take about 0.5 grams of your edible material. You can weigh that out, or a pinch. You know, you can pinch it off of the thing if you just want a relative accuracy test. You put that inside your reaction vial, and then you dump your solution inside, about a mil to 2 mils. There's a line there that shows you how much to fill the reaction vial up. Then you'll take your dye solution inside your amber bottle, open that up, put that inside, and sit for about minutes, just like the other detections as well. This detection is a little more powerful. Since edibles, it's hard to separate the THC from the actual material that it cooks in with.
Let me ask you this. When you're testing an edible, most likely you're testing for THC, not THCA, okay? When you're testing the bud that we talked about earlier, and for THC and CBD, we're talking about THC and CBDA, correct?
Yes, you would be talking about the THC carboxylic acid, and with the edible, you would be looking just for the straight THC.
Right. So,
and
go ahead.
Yeah, Alan. Our detection actually looks for both of them, doesn't make a distinction between either one of them, but looks for both of them because both would be present in either material. For the THC detection kit in the edible, yes, it looks for the THC, and for the THC detection kit for just the bud, it looks for the THCA.
So let me ask you this. I'm a novice in some ways. You know, I've been using this plant for 47, 48 years, but I'm still learning every day. When you test the 0.03 grams of bud for THC and CBD, when you come up with that percentage of A, the acid, when that converts to just THC, how different is the percentage from when it was? Is it totally get converted from A to?
Sure. I'll tell you about that. So most of the time when you decarboxylate THCA into THC, most all of it, 98 to 99% of it gets converted to THC. And the reason why our detection kits can scan for both and do scan for both is because the molecular mass between the two compounds don't vary that much. And it scans for just the delta-9 tetrahydrocannabinol aspect of the molecules itself, with or without the carboxylic acid. So that's how you can scan for both. So most of it does get converted over to THC, if not all of it in most circumstances. And the bud that you actually hold in your hand, it's very interesting because some of that is THC and not just THCA, a very small percentage, maybe 1% to 2%. But that's due to time. Carboxylic acid can break off over time, and it's interesting. But going back to your question about how potent our tests, our detection kits are compared to a lab analysis, you're not going to get a full detection unless you have a very expensive chromatography machine, HPLC, UPC squared, something like that. And what this detection kit is for is, of course, just like you said, for the patients, for people at home who want to know. It's an instant detection. It's going to vary, of course, a little bit between, actual lab analysis that gives you the exact percentage, say 25 to 50% THC in your edibles or concentrates or whatever. But that's what our detection kit is used for. The UPREP kit, that lab has those chromatographic methods. They have some of the most powerful chromatography tools known to man and known to the cannabis industry, which is awesome. We work with other labs, too, that use really intense chromatography measures and analysis aspects. So we pride ourselves off of our detection kits. We really like them.
Give me a little bit of a history. How did you get started in wanting to do these home kits, and how long has it taken you to get to this point?
Sure. When we started this industry, we saw that there was a lot of non-regulation. There wasn't that much regulation in this industry at all, and especially especially with edibles. This is a big situation California is facing. And our biggest thing is knowledge and regulation. We want regulation for this industry. This helps regulation, and this helps states decide laws for this industry, you know, and that helps get things moving along, especially in places, you know, places around that aren't yet medical or aren't yet recreation. So that's our main purpose, is to get this, you know, what we consider medicine out there.
So who's your main customers right now? Is it the patients? Is it the end user?
Our main focus is on the health patients, because I believe, you know, I talked to patients out of time on conference a couple of months ago with lots of parents, and I understand when, you know, somebody get product and it's high on THC and you're thinking you're getting low dosage and your kids starting to get sick from that, you know, it's break hard to everybody. I mean, you know, we want to educate and you know, the potency test, it's about on the end of the day for the patients, because if you want to get exactly what you need, you know, this is the way how you can secure a position getting exactly what you want. If we have full test on the labels, what you're receiving, because, you know, each body it's different, and everybody we need the different for, you know, to be healed or, you know, get the correct result. And this is the part when, you know, when we coming to the table and offering our services to provide what we're providing.
Are you also selling this product out of the country, or are people from Europe and Spain and other places?
I'm originally from Europe, and, you know, I'm originally from Czechoslovakia. This is my accent coming from. We are big in hemp, you know, for hundreds of years. And of course, Czech Republic is the first country to legalize medical marijuana. And it's amazing, you know, what I talk into different distributors. I mean, you know, we right now building network distributors in Europe, you know, and we are very, very happy what's going on right now with our products over there.
It's very exciting, obviously. And let me ask you, testing for pesticides and heavy metals, okay,
is
something that's very important. Up in Colorado, they quarantined a bunch of plants, a bunch of edible products as well. Your products here, which test kit can test for heavy metals and pesticides, if you do have one, or do you have to send in the UPREP for that?
Yeah, it's UPREP, because, you know, this is need to go through the laboratory, you know, through the machines. You cannot do it in from, you know, pocket or, you know, home test kit,
right.
You know.
So how much would it cost for a patient who had some concerns to send in a test for heavy metals and pesticides? What would it cost a patient to do that?
You know, we right now working on, you know, when we CB Scientific and UPREP, you know, we get together, you know, working right now, you know, like one group, you know, we helping to bring our, you know, knowledge in the industry from the marketing sides and from packaging. I mean, we help them, because right now it's cost around $250 Canadian, you know. I mean, we're trying to in the next 30 days, you know, come with a little bit better price for U.S. market.
So basically right now, for patients who want to have something tested for heavy metals or pesticides, it's really cost prohibitive for a patient to do that at this point.
Yes.
Okay.
It's most for grower, because if you're growing and you know, you climb, you know, you are organic grower, and right now you will do the test and you find, you know, your soil have lots of heavy metals and lots of from fertilizers for many, many years. So, I mean, we'll come with the solution. Right now we're working when we can fix your soil properly in 3-4 months, and now you will have no heavy metals.
Okay. You know, all right, so let's talk about how people can get these kits. It's test4cbd.com. You have your own shopping cart there. And right now you have four products, is that correct? You have one for edibles, one for CBD only, one for THC only, and then a THC and CBD combo kit. How can people order these today, and what's your turnaround?
You just go on the online, and you just order, and you know, when we, you know, our customer service will receive email, you order, so we'll go to, you know, to a different department, go to our warehouse, and you know, every time when we're getting the orders, next day is our ship out.
Okay, and is there a shipping charge, or is that included in your price for the product?
It's shipping charge on the website. I mean, you know, for shipping and handling charge, it's on the website.
Fantastic. And you said you might have a coupon code for people who are listening to this broadcast?
Yes, of course. I can, you know, let's go come with some. What your idea, and we'll give $3 off of the price because somebody listened to our show right now.
Fantastic. So just mention Medical Marijuana Radio if you want to order these test kits, and that might cover part of your shipping.
Anybody who will use code MMR will get $3 off.
MMR, that's for Medical Marijuana Radio. Very good. Alan and Henry, thank you very much for enlightening our audience. I think what you're doing is definitely necessary. We need products for home testing. You guys seem to be doing it. Do you have competition, or are you pretty much have this market to your own yourself right now?
So everybody's coming with different products. You know, we happy, you know, when anybody will come with some good ideas, you know, just under our test for kids. I think we are just right now on the market, just us, you know, on the laboratory, it's many, many great laboratories. And just, it's again, it's everything under how the people want to be, you know, what's fits for them. So, right. I mean, we find niche and pattern when, you know, you can get your result, you know, in 3-5 days, and it's fully laboratory, and it's fast.
Sure.
And it's, I believe it's cost effective.
Alan, how does your device compare to, let's say, some of the little boxes that are being produced now? There's something called MyDX, and then I think there's some larger type box that people are using.
We've definitely taken a look at MyDX, and it looks like a very interesting device. And apparently it smells the cannabis for the cannabinoids inside the cannabis. It's just that's a very price prohibitive in our mind, instead of having a simple little detection kit like this. And it's not going to give you a full lab analysis from a certified laboratory. But MyDX definitely looks like a very interesting device, and we can't wait to get our hands on one of those.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see, you know, the comparison on the results, to see how close each other is on this. But you had one more thing you wanted to say, Alan?
Yeah, also they have little thin layer chromatography kits on the market. These kits can go for anywhere from $200 to $300. And that's like the base chromatography method that's out there. It's still kind of colometrics, and it gives you a certain percentage. So that's another route you can go. It's just, again, it's similar to our detection kit. It's a lot more steps. Our detection kit is just 3 steps, and it's about $200 to $300 instead of what you would pay for us.
Gotcha. Well, I appreciate what you guys are doing. It's definitely needed to have a home kit for patients to see what they're putting in their bodies. We have a medical cannabis program here in New Mexico. They have mandatory testing. We have 3 or 4 labs that are now approved, and nobody's testing. So it's really up to the Department of Health and the medical cannabis programs to enforce their own rules and get better medicine out to the patient. So I want to thank both Alan and Henry from CB Scientific, and again, the website is test, the number 4cbd.com. Use coupon code MMR for $3 off your order. That'll cover part of your shipping. And I want to thank both of you for talking to our audience today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My
Bye-bye.
Pleasure. We'll be right back after these words.
Thank you. better get some sleep tonight, honey. Better get some sleep tonight. They say you are hot as the sun goes down. They say more shadows crawl.
I want to thank Alan and Henry from CB Scientific. If you want to test your medicine and you want to do it at home and you want to know what the strength is, that's the place to go. Check them out. Don't forget the code MMR for $3 off. That'll help with your shipping. Thank you again. Also, I want to thank my two radio mentors, both with the initials HS. Thank you for your inspiration. And don't forget my weekly show, Wednesdays with Larawana, on canawanabuy.com. That's canawanabuy.com if you're a head shop, a patient, a dispensary, all kinds of great products, fast shipping, and great prices. canawanabuy.com. Also, if you want to hear replays of this show, medicalmarijuanaradio.com, mmjradio.com. My YouTube channel is LSLove88. On SoundCloud, it's MMJ Radio, and Spreaker, MMJ Radio. Also on Spreaker, it's Time for Hemp. Time for Hemp puts it up on iHeartRadio.com. That's iHeart.com. CannabisTube.net, we're on. Also on Now TV, channel 937. Also 420radio.org, Pothead Universe Radio. And on the Roku box, it's the U.S. Weed Channel. info@mmjradio.com info@mmjradio.com if you'd like to write us.